Should you mix your own chicken feed? Well, the answer seems like an obvious yes, right? But wait, wait. It's a bit more complicated than that. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the intricacies involved in mixing your own chicken feed. And I'm also going to be sharing with you how I've managed and handled the mixing of my own feeds in order to maintain the maximum productivity. So welcome back to FarmUp. My name is Daniel, as you might know, a practicing medical doctor. And just like you, most likely, I started out on poultry farming when I was naive, completely naive. No experience, no knowledge, very little money, but I've made it. I've learned my lessons, and on this channel, I want to share these lessons with you to teach you so that you're as productive as possible, so that you earn money quicker in a simpler way. So please, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell that way you don't miss out on any of my uploads. Also, if you like anything in the video or if you like the video in general, don't forget to hit that like button. Now, I know you've heard the stories, you know, you need to mix your own chicken feed because it is the highest cost ever. Now, that's very true. Chicken feeds are the highest cost in poultry production. But do you really need to mix your own feed? That's a very complex question to answer, coming from my own experience, and we're going to answer it in this video. What you need to know is that there are payoffs or sacrifices when you choose to mix your own feeds, especially at the beginning, because I've done it. I did it, and right now I'm doing a mixture of mixing my own feeds and not mixing my own feeds. Sounds a bit complicated right now, right? But you'll understand me. Now, what you need to know is that there are basic components of chicken feed. Carbohydrate, vitamins, fats, calcium, and other minerals, then proteins. Then the different sources for these things vary, yeah? For carbohydrate, the most common and most commonly used is maize grain, you know, maize grain and whole maize, that is it, and maize bran. And then other people use, you know, rice husks, wheat pollard. Then vitamins naturally can be gotten from vegetables. Then calcium from limestone, that's what I use. Other people use eggshells. Fats, again, can be gotten from corn. And then proteins, which can be gotten from things like soybean, sunflower, fish meal. But when it comes to commercial birds, the most important of all these things are the proteins. We all know that proteins are bodybuilding foods. Those things they taught us when we were in elementary school, primary. Proteins are bodybuilding foods. And the birds are very, very sensitive to proteins. For example, if you're talking about broilers, let's say the starter feed, it must be 22%, around 22% protein. And then the grower, around 19% protein. When it comes to the layers, the laying birds, the percentage of the protein needs to be around 18%. Now, if this percentage of the protein is too low or too high, the productivity of the birds automatically decreases. The other thing that we need to know is that, for example, chicken egg is more than 70% protein and water. Then again, chicken meat, that the one we eat, is mainly muscle. And what are muscles? Muscles are proteins. Now, if you're going to be mixing your own feeds, what you need to know is that you're going to have to be very, very careful with the proteins. And that is the hardest part of the story. Let's take an example. If you're going to be using soybean or soya, depending on where you come from, you'll call it something different. You need to make sure that soybean is roasted, yeah? Because chickens are not given raw soybean, yeah? It contains a particular amino acid which is very toxic to the birds, yeah? So you need to make sure that the soybean has been roasted and it is ready, yeah? If it gets overburnt, you destroy everything. And then if it is raw, it is very harmful to the birds. Number two, the source of the soybean. You know, there are different types of soybean on the market, yeah? You need to make sure you're going to be getting the same exact kind of soybean every time in order to maintain consistency. Number three, if you're going to be using things like fish meal, I think is like the worst if you're using it all around here. Why? Because if you've noticed guys who harvest fish from the lake. These guys go harvest the fish, then they will put it down somewhere to dry. What happens? Birds, wild birds, you know, all kinds of things. The local chickens around, they come and start, you know, scratching around. They poop in it and they do all those things. So by the time the fish meal comes to your farm, the highest likelihood is that it's going to be contaminated. Same thing with the other things, you know, sunflower, cotton seed cake. All those things are very difficult to control the percentage of the protein or the quality. So whilst it might be very easy for you to calculate the amounts of feeds needed, for example, make 18% protein, you're going to have a very hard time maintaining the quality of those proteins. The other thing is that chickens are very sensitive to change of feed. You know, they're just like us humans. You know, I have a friend from who came over from South America. They came to Uganda, here in Uganda, and they wanted food, but getting them food was very complicated. Everything I gave them, they didn't like. The food is very delicious for me. It's not as delicious for them. Why? Because they are changing. Yeah. Every time there is change, just like it is for us human beings, they have a problem adapting. Yeah. If I move to Asia, for example, I'll have a problem eating seafood because I haven't grown up eating seafood. Now, these are chickens, and that change in feeds will even affect them more. It will cause increases in stress levels. So notice this. Every time you're going to be bringing in, you know, maize from another source, you're going to be bringing in soybean and then fish meal from different sources. Every time there's a difference in those feeds, the chickens are going to be getting stressed. So don't be shocked if the productivity falls down. Let me give you a story of what happened on my poultry farm. When I was starting out, I used a concentrate which needed me to add soybean, sunflower, limestone, maize bran, and whole maize. Yeah. So the concentrate really just had, you know, the probiotics, coccidiostat drugs, and the essential amino acids that are not present usually in the feeds, and vitamins. But I was mixing the biggest percentage of my chicken feed. I'd go out and source all these other components, bring them to the farm, and mix them myself. But you know what happened? My birds started lying at 22 weeks of age. They're supposed to start laying at 18 weeks. They started at 22 weeks. That was a whole month later. That means I suffered losses. I lost out already for a whole month. Then later what happened is that I got the concentrate that I currently use. Now, if you're in a country like Uganda, where there's a lot of poultry farming, there are going to be a lot of chicken concentrates on the market. Very many different types, yeah? So I got one that I was told was good. And it's what I used. Now, that concentrate only needed me to add limestone, which is a source of calcium, the maize bran, and the broken maize. None of these is a very important source of the protein. So the protein had already been, you know, mixed and made from the factory. And that's very important because at the factory, they can maintain the percentage of the protein at the required level. The quality is good and the percentage is exactly what it's supposed to be. So the production of my birds went up, like really, really up. I was getting, you know, maximum production. And then the lockdown happened, as you guys might already know. And when the lockdown happened, the inflow of that particular concentrate was interrupted. The concentrate disappeared. So I had to go back to an initial concentrate. And with the initial concentrate, the maximum that my birds were laying was 66%. 66% laying. For birds that were laying at 86%, that is a very big percentage. Just to let you know, that was around $15 I was losing every day. And mind you, I was doing my very best to source everything from the highest quality that I could get. So I looked for the best quality soybean that I could get, the best quality sunflower, the best quality fish meal that I could get. But the best that I could get to was 66% for me. Now, I know there are people who get higher, yeah? But the stories I've had and the people I've shared with, the highest they ever go is 76%. And the shocking bit is that at that time, when I was mixing my own feeds, there was no big difference in price, yeah? With the previous concentrate and the new one where I was literally mixing the feeds myself, there was only a difference of $3 for the feeds every day. So while I was losing around $15 in production of eggs, I was only saving $3 in the chicken feed. That just doesn't make sense. So this is it. If you're going to be keeping broilers or layers in particular, it's very, very hard for me to recommend that you mix your own feeds, because these birds are very sensitive to the feeds, unless you don't have, you know, other feeds around, or unless the feeds are just too expensive for you, yeah? Unless they're just too expensive. But if the difference is, you know, $3 or $4, you know, a very small percentage in the difference, I would advise you to go for the concentrates or, you know, already pre-mixed feeds. Now, the feeds I use, like I've told you, are not really totally mixed feeds, yeah? I just use the concentrate and then whole maize, maize bran, and limestone. That simply means that I still have, you know, the free way to go and play with the prices. For example, I'll buy maize and maize bran at a time when it's very cheap, keep it on my farm for the times when it's very expensive. And the way I mix my feeds is that a bag of 50 kilograms of the concentrate mixes 250 kilograms of feed. So the whole 200 kilograms I can still play around with, and it's not as sensitive, yeah? But the 50 kilograms, where the protein actually is, that I cannot compromise with. Now, are there times where it is okay to mix your own feeds? Of course, yeah? There are times, for example, if you're keeping mixed breeds, you know, for example, in Nigeria, I think they're called Noilers. Here in Uganda, we have Croilers, we have Sasso birds, we have Kenbro coming in from Kenya, yeah? If you're keeping such kinds of birds, it is very okay for you to mix your own feeds. Why? Because these birds have a very good feed conversion rate. Like they're very good at extracting, you know, even the least of the nutrients from the feed, yeah? So you keep such birds, mix your own feeds, you know? Or if you're keeping indigenous birds, mix your own feeds. I don't advise you to go for commercial feeds completely if you're keeping those birds. And then again, if you're keeping, you know, layers or broilers, again, you can mix your own feeds, but you have to be very, very good at it. Do I dream of mixing my own feeds? Yes, of course, someday I'm going to be mixing my own feeds, yeah? But that's if I can get all the different ingredients at a very good quality, and I can mix the feeds in such a way that I can actually test the quality of the feed. If I can't do that, then I shall not mix my own feeds. Okay, I mix my own feeds, but in part, you know, partially. So if you're choosing to mix your own feeds, I would advise you to source all your ingredients from high quality sources, which is the complex bit, yeah? Because if you're mixing your own feeds, what you're trying to avoid are high expenses. And you avoid, how do you avoid high expenses? By going, you know, to the local people to get the soybean from someone you know, to get the sunflower from someone you know, and that makes things complex. Now, in my next upload, I'm going to be sharing with you guys and explaining to you how to actually mix your own feeds. If you've chosen and you've decided that you're going to be mixing your own feeds, I'm going to be sharing with you the ratios and everything of how to mix your own feeds. But I had to bring this video up first because a lot of people were asking me to teach them how to mix their own feeds. And I had reservations about this because of the experience I went through and because of the experience I know many other people have gone through, yeah? So I want you to know the story of what could happen if you mix your own feeds. And if you have such information, it will be easy for you to know that, you know, I think the production has gone down because I think the soybean wasn't roasted very well, or maybe the fish meal was bad. That way it will be easy for you to adjust. You can watch more of my videos right here, and please click here to subscribe. See you guys next week on the same channel. Thanks for watching.